Mithra!
Called it.
Will you show him, Mithra?
Fox.
Thank you.
Okay, now we're back. And here we go. The battlefield stage lends itself well to ladders, and Fox is one of the mightiest ladder combo characters of them all. Really, Nintendo did a masterful job playing around that blunderbuss, just staying just out of range. Keeping his first stock here and at a dangerous percent where any good hit should be it. That wasn't quite it. Surprising. Here we go. Up tilt for the first stock of this game. So close. Just not quite able to find that window. That'll do it. It's an interesting matchup because on paper, Fox has a lot of anti-zoning and powerful combos, but the big thing is that you have to respect K. Rool's belly armor, and since Fox is so light, he does not have a large room for error. Like that. Boom. Just proving both of my points at once with that perfectly timed F-tilt. Nice combo. Just not quite able to take the stock. Back air still not enough? Okay, we're all one of the heaviest characters in the game after all. Just... I'm Tendo getting really desperate with those up smash spamming. None of them will found up the mark. Good. But finds the back air to close out the second stock. Fighting a bit of an uphill battle, but it's still either player's game, potentially. Ooh, and there we go. A well-timed nair to escape the pressure. Another nair forcing him back. Here we go! Ouch! Big damage. Up smash, not enough on that platform. And against K. Rool at that percent. Another up smash, just barely not enough. Last hit, and that is going to be the game. Game count. Okay. Here we go. Nintendo's. Oh. What game is that? Yep, this is Winner's Finals, so Nintendo still in it. Got the chance to advance onto Winner's side, but he's gonna have to win the next two games. Tall order against the king of the Crocs. I could have made that sound a lot less awkward. Here we go. Just ledge trapping him to death potentially. Respect to that option, and doesn't. Now it's reset to neutral. There's a good up throw. Yeah, catches him with the up air. Just guessed the wrong direction a little bit, and there we go. One of the classic combos into up smash for the first stock. Yeah, catching his air dodge. Good respect on the blunderbuss. Just barely misses the chance to grab to force him back off stage. Oh, it's also a bit tricky when dealing with... Oh no! That is going to do it! Design Tendo in a spot where he has to use the up B and counters it for the stock. Smart stuff for Moa. Ooh, runs right into the blunderbuss. There's a smarter use of it and turns it right around. Now, ooh, gets clipped by the up B, interrupting his ledge trapping pressure. Good punish by Oa. Ooh, and hitting all the right reads, trying to go deep for that, and not able to get back. Went too low. I was worried that it might happen with the up air just because of how long the lag, end lag is on it. But since it sends him slightly upward, I guess they thought it would be a bit too much if he could actually use it for major recovery assistance, so they just gave it the most end lag of any up air in the game, and that's one of the dangers of it. Usually not a problem when you use it on stage, but off stage, there's where the problem lies. This is definitely I'm Tendo's game to lose, but it's still within grasp of Oa, especially since you never want to count Oa out. Almost taking the stock, but seems like the staling just kept it from that from happening. And that should be it. Game 5 on deck. It all comes down to this. Getting the first hits from the... And here we go! Interesting that he didn't go for a third one. I see he just recognized that I wasn't going to get truly comboed by a third one, and so just ended off the pressure there. That's what's so scary about Fox's pressure. Once he's on you, you have to pick the perfect option to escape, and if you don't, you're just going to get thrown into the vortex over and over until you do, or the percentages get so high that the vortex is no longer a viable option. Yeah, interesting that he didn't try to go for a follow-up on that dash attack. Got a bit too greedy there and eats the... Oh no, this could be trouble. Smartly going a bit high, catching Oa off guard to allow himself to recover. Once again, getting caught by the Nair to be in the process, getting forced back. But there we go. Great shield pressure to find that back air. Landed high and eats the F tilt. I'm Tendo answering back. Not quite able to take the stock. Good punish. Good jump from Oa to not give him that up air. good avoidance on the F tilt. And up smash got the sour spot. And that only landed because K-Rolls is so big. Normally, that's not a great option if they land on the wrong side of your shield. Likely to at a too high of a percent for the up smash confirms to work reliably. So you're going to have to work a bit harder to find that finishing blow. Or dash attack will allow him to land it for free. That dash attack is very unsafe on shield. Ooh, the landing hitbox catching Oa off guard. I'm Tendo not pressing his luck here. Knows that he doesn't. Now starting to press his advantage. Oof. Things are not looking good for Oa here. Back air. Ooh, probably could have gotten the up air punish if he had been more ready for it. That up air is incredibly laggy. Catches him and Blunderbuss will take the stock. Oha doesn't have a lot of room for error here. He's come back from worse, though. And not going to get the chance with the ledge trump for the match. Reverse 3-0 from I'm Tendo.
Are you about to do
Yeah, we have a Street Fighter side bracket tonight. It's Street Fighter's fun. But don't have too much else to say about it right now. I haven't played Street Fighter 6 before. So I think next up we've got Meeks and Sunny T on stream. Meeks does not like being commentated, being able to hear commentary over him, due to technical issues, I wasn't able to set it up further. So for this one, for this match, I will respectfully be keeping quiet. So be back after this, if Meeks doesn't continue further, that is.
Battle.
Thomas. Three, two, one, go! start the battle. Thomas.
Go!
Thomas.
And that was a very hard-fought set between Sunny T and Meeks. Sunny T just barely clutching it out. It's an interesting one because, well, the big problem for Samus in that matchup is that since there's so much stuff that Duck Hunt is always putting out, Charge Shot rarely has a chance to connect. And so Meeks made an admirable effort to try and make every single Charge Shot count, but just was not quite able to close it out tonight. Still, Sunny T really had to struggle for some of those stocks. Duck Hunt notoriously very bad at finding the kills. But with that, we now have Ant and Sunny T up. I think you need to report still. Oh, you have the ability to self-report.
Yeah.
Good. I think they should give me the ability to report, but they don't. But for some wacky reason, they didn't bother. I think it's because they just want it to be a habit to have to report the score. Still. Sunny T versus Ant. Much more different match than the last one. I mean, Hero does have that neutral B, which has some similarities with Samus, but not a ton. Samus's neutral charge shot is basically an all-purpose utility move, while for Hero, it's generally strictly a KO option. That should be the... delayed him with the clever use of the neutral B, but just not able to... But ultimately, it just delayed the inevitable. Yeah, that's a huge problem for Duck Hunt in this matchup. Once Bounce is out, basically has to do nothing but scrap, and that is not where Duck Hunt's strengths lie. Oof. Just barely avoiding that charge shot. Ooh, just barely missing that up smash. And Ant going way deep for the edge guard. That's what you can do is with that accelerado, folks. Just you go so fast that you can just go way out there. And Sunny T finally finding a stock with the up smash. Oh boy, here we go again. Trying to go for the cheese, probably would have been, might have been able to get the down air on that, go up the, just, then again, I'm not entirely sure if he would have been able to recover, so. Sometimes it's good to have your priorities straight. Can only really know after the fact with some analysis. if they would have been able to get back. Ooh, and there we go. Game one to Ant. Go game two, going to Moonside Battlefield. Sunny T has a affinity for that. Starting out not too bad. Interesting. That side B is a big challenge for dealing with Hero. Just it's so big, covers so much range, and it's not actually a projectile, so. A lot of your standard anti-projectile options don't work on against Hero side B. Finding the fully powered back air for the first stock. As the Christmas tree finally gets escapes. Not really able to get much started. Gets caught a bit by the... And oof! A very good edge guard for the second stock. Now with a two-stock lead, it seems like Ant's running away with this game. It is going to take a miracle for Sunny Tiki. Not going to get the chance either with that neutral beat. Proving my point that that thing is just, it is for finishing out the stocks. Sorry, watered down the wrong pipe. And now on match points after that very dominant last game. Going to Yoshi's Story. That's an interesting pick. I guess he's looking for ways to cheese stocks, or just being able to take stocks. And there we go. That might be the... Yep. That's Yoshi's Story, all right. Granted, that side B is powerful, crazy powerful. Still, just... I don't think that would have been able to take stock at that percent without... it being Battlefield. Oh boy. Oh boy! This counter pick is backfiring quite badly for Sunny T. just trying to finish it out with the smash text is not... None of them quite doing the job, getting sizzled. Oof! And gets the reverse edge guard in a destruction for game three. Well, that's... Not sure what we were expecting. That is a pretty bad matchup for...
I'm gonna put that
bad matchup for Duck Hunt. Just doesn't have disjoint... Gets disjointed, out-disjointed quite badly, and has no... And once the bounce comes out, very little Duck Hunt can do about it. And the fact that Duck Hunt notoriously struggles to find a stock is all the more painful against a character who can buff themselves through the roof and take yours at 60. Still, it's on the player to learn how to overcome those bad matchups if they want to really become the best. I could buy it. It is an interesting thought. Sometimes you do have to there is weight. It's a trade-off of playing one character, or two characters, or three characters, we're on to the next match. Oh, pulling out the Ridley. Ridley is an interesting one. Quite explosive, but also a lot more vulnerable. Really? Did you just taunt after losing your stock? Oh, he did take the stock first. Okay, you have every right to taunt after that. Oh, good air dodge to escape the death trap. Not quite. Oh, Dane. Forward smash battle and Ant does not come out on top there. Finally taking the stock with a powered up forward air. The only way that was ever gonna take the stock is if it had been a fully powered crit, which that's like what? One in a thousand? I guess he could have tried to go for whack or thwack, but that's not much. The odds on that aren't much better. Oof. Catches him landing on stage, which is a good thing against Accelerado. Surprised the fire didn't break him right out. Flex him for the second stock. It becomes more and more likely the higher the percentage gets. What buff was that? It looks like it glitched out somehow. Or was it... It's still either player's game here, surprisingly. Oh, a bit low on mana. And that is going to take the game. What a steal. on the game two. Is, oh, I'm really gonna let Ant just demolish his Ridley here. Ooh, nice combo to start that. Showing the power of the hero up air. It's a very unconventional up air. It feels more like a... doesn't really feel like a swordy up air. It's closer to, like, Mario's up air. Ooh, and gets the psych up for this first stock. Nice catch on the air dodge. Really just tried to end him there. Trying to stuff out the edge guard, but it's very hard to nail down a hero with Accelerado. And that should be the... And with the crit, it absolutely is the second stock. Finally get answering back with taking Ant's first stock this game. But this is game right now is Ant's to lose. But if any player here can make him lose a game from here, it is Oa. Oh, just trying to find the finishing blow. Forward air does it. Ant now on match point. Is Oa gonna stick with the Ridley here? Go. Or finally pull back out the K rule. This depends on how much he wants and feels like winning tonight. Okay. It is Ridley or nothing tonight. Well, I respect him for sticking to his guns here, but yeah. See if it pays off. Definitely not looking too much better than last game so far. And there goes the first stock. Getting the jab to force him back off stage. Oh no! It pineapples himself for the first stock. That might be the gateway back into this game and match Oa needs. Just getting smacked back off stage over and over. Good call out on the get up neutral B. That's one of Ant's favorite tricks. Ooh, and catches him trying to get back on the stage high for the second stock. Using the sizzle to go right through it. And that's going to be the stock. Not even a question. You have to be so careful shielding against Hero because at a moment's notice, your shield will be deleted. This is a, really, dash attack does it. Oh, definitely caught a lucky break from Ant's SD that game. But we'll see how much it matters for the rest of this match. So far, starting out this game, well, this game's starting out pretty even. It's possible that Ant, with that SD last game, threw away his best chance to eliminate Oa from the tournament. This is definitely looking a lot better for Oa, just keeping Ant on the back foot. That is not quite going to be the first stock. Almost got the up air on the stage landing. Has another psych up, which it's a dangerous game he's playing. Back air not quite enough. Really trying to stall out his recovery. Gaz another. Yeah, gonna throw him off stage. Uh-oh. Just barely able to recover there. Ooh, that was a good mix-up. Just making him wonder what he's gonna go and then just running up and attacking. Oof, catches him with the boom, not quite enough. Ooh, catches him rolling with that neutral B. What a lucky break. Or a very good read. A bit hard to tell if Oa just narrowly got clipped by it. Doing a great job pressuring him with the up airs. Ooh, what happened there? He definitely took the brunt of the kaboom, but somehow it didn't send him flying. That was so weird. Okay, gets the grab, gonna put him off stage, gets the up smash on the platform for that second stock. Back air, almost clutching it out. Once again, Oa is showing good patience. And using the fear factor with the menu to great effect yet again. Just barely missing the crackle slash. Oa does not have a lot of room for error here, especially with psych up on deck. Swack missing. And that is going to do it. Oa being eliminated from the tournament. Was it arrogance? Was it pride? Wait, that's the same thing, isn't it? But either way, it would seem that Oa's hubris with the Ridley cost him his way back into Grands. Which means we only have one question for Oa, if he dares answer. Was it worth it? What? Well, fair enough. I mean, he does have a Ridley 8-bit thing alongside the K-roll, so he takes it his Ridley pretty seriously, it would seem. Just did not pan out there. With that out of the way, we'll see if Ant can get his revenge on I'm Tendo. They fought in winner's semis, and it did not go well for him there. So this run back, we'll see if he can take a game or even the tournament. And here we go. Let's get this show on the road, folks. Grand finals on deck. I'm Tendo versus Ant. Said this did not go well for Ant earlier. See if he can make a difference here. It's definitely can definitely see why he'd struggled earlier. The awkward matchup, considering that Heroes framed that as not great, and with how good Fox is at suffocating characters, it's very hard for Hero to get in a lot of opportunities to even menu. First stock with the well-timed up air. There's a good read. That's another scary thing. Wow! What an angle! I'm Tendo chose like the perfect angle to get through all that and just barely get back to stage. Finch struggling to find the first knock and gets edge guarded for the second one. Rare footage of I'm Tendo edge guarding with Fox. Yeah. Fox generally isn't a great edge guarding character. His fast falling speed and his not great air mobility just generally doesn't make it the greatest idea. Still, sometimes there are those openings where you just go for it and it works. Keeping the pressure up, finally, once again, restarting the pressure, just up smashes him out of nowhere. And there we go. Game one to I'm Tendo. Game 2, going to Battlefield. There's definitely more combo potential for Hero to utilize here, though it's also not a terrible stage for Fox, because his up airs are a huge part of his game plan. He can absolutely maximize those on this stage. Yeah, that's the tricky, one of the tricky things about Fox. His Nair is so safe, so try and do anything and he'll usually be able to punish it with a jab. Not able to get any further up airs to send him to the blast zone. Ooh, gets the back air punish on the forward smash. Answers back with the classic up smash punish on the missed tech. Oof! Just going for the neutral B for the damage. That's not something you see can't do too often. That should be the second stock. Now with a full stock lead, definitely getting all the right reads on I'm Tendo at the moment. See if he can keep it up. There we go. Oh, a very well-timed get up. Not quite able to finish him out with the edge guarding. Psych up. Good choice of options to force it off stage. Ooh, that was dangerously small amount of shield left there. I feel like Ant intended to do that up the off stage and miss into the input on that. Nintendo struggling to close out the second stock. Very much Ant's game to lose here. And gets the down smash. Sounds like it might have been a crit, but it also... Well, Fox is also pretty light, so I don't know if that it would have been strictly necessary to take the stock. That's one to... for the rewatch, I guess. But Ant taking a game, which is already a big step up from their previous fight. Yeah. Sneaky side B onto the stage for to get up. And missed the opportunity to snuff out the stock to punish. Ooh, interesting. Ouch, that's gonna hurt. Yeah, not a lot the Ant could do from that position. Was just gonna have to hope for the uppie or try and zoom to get back to stage. Zoom is not guaranteed. Oh, gets the accelerado edge guard for the first stock, keeping it close. Here we go. Finally gets out, but as a result of that wasted time, the Christmas tree is gone. Which is fair. Christmas isn't for another few months. Ooh, trying to go for the forward smash to snuff out the stock, but finds a side B into up air to do the same things. Didn't make a huge difference. Interesting that he... And that was definitely a crit. That's the power of crits, people. They just delete stocks at very low percents. Very even game here. It could go either way. Oh, good follow-ups. Setting them, keeping them in the air. Just barely missing that back air. Yeah, that's gonna... Oh, smart. I'm tender recognizing that his only way back to recover was to go for the other ledge. And catches Ant on the landing for the game. Nintendo on tournament point. Barely not able to get the down air to really solidify it, though. Also, can't Fox wall jump? So I'm not sure if that would have been an easy edge guard anyways. Maybe I'm mistaken. Pretty sure I'm mistaken now, but... Yeah, it doesn't matter too much. Gets the zoom for the safe recovery. Ooh, and the kaboom just sending him to the blast zone. Yep, not able to recover from there. Good recognition on Nintendo to go for that edge guard to ensure the stock. Pays to pay attention to the hero's mana at times. Very good combo from the accelerado. Catches him missing the tech there. Good reflect on the kaboom. Smart use of the nair to force him back to neutral. Catches him with the forward air to get back to stage. And gets caught by the down air into up smash confirm for the second stock. Another good use of the reflect to stay safe from the kaboom. Just not giving Ant a chance to breathe. Yeah. Yeah, good recognition on the neutral getup, but F tilt not quite enough. Good angle mix up to make it hard for. Oh, but made a big mistake going high with that one. Eats the back air for the second stock. Ooh, that was an interesting mix up, but it and catches him with that last up air for the match and tournament. Yep, that's the danger of counterpicking to triplats. You give Fox more opportunities to land up airs. And a stage like that. Huh? Wait. Okay. I got it. I was keeping track of the matches. So that's it for tonight, folks. Sorry for the stream issues earlier. I'll see if I can get things working better next time. So till then.